President Zuma and activist Crawford-Browne appear to have reached an agreement over their constitutional court's battle over the arms deal, and both government and business delegation from South Africa and Oman will work together to ensure that all agreements that they have entered into are implemented. Ambosisi Wagadebe with the latest news update. President Jacob Zuma and activist Terry Crawford-Browne appear to have reached an agreement over their constitutional court battle over the arms deal. The court says Crawford-Browne's lawyers have informed them that they have settled their dispute. The two parties are due to appear in court today with a copy of the draft order. Crawford-Browne had gone to the court to force Zuma to institute a commission of inquiry into the arms deal. Zuma appointed an inquiry in September and issued the terms of reference before the matter could be argued before the court. Senior Constitutional Court reporter Candace Klein has the details.
Crawford-Browne says he'll happily withdraw the case if the Constitutional Court gives the green light on the use of sitting judges.
But they're happy with the use of sitting rather than retired judges. The commission's work could not then be challenged, say, 2 years down the road.
Zuma's lawyers are against these conditions, saying Crawford-Browne has not made out a proper case for such intervention, and that his request interferes with the separation of powers between the executive and the judiciary. Zuma earlier offered to pay Crawford-Browne's legal costs from the initial application. According to a media release from the court, an agreement has been reached and will be brought before the court. Candace Klein, SABC News, Johannesburg.
Part of a contract by the company On Point benefiting suspended ANC Youth League president Julius Malema has been put on hold. However, the Public Protector's Office says the contract cannot be cancelled in its entirety because it will have serious legal implications. Public Protector Tulima Donsela has met with the Limpopo Roads and Transport Department, and both parties agreed to suspend the participation of On Point in the Bid Evaluation Committee until the investigation is concluded. On Point Engineering is partly owned by Malema's family trust. Madonsela is probing claims that the Limpopo government awarded irregular tenders to On Point, which benefited Malema. State Security Minister Siyabonga Cwele has dispelled any hope that the state will heed pressure to include a public interest defense in the Protection of State Information Bill. Cwele has told a National Assembly debate on the bill the ANC has agreed to many changes to the draft law but will not budge on calls to allow publication of secret information because it is in the public interest.
The question is who determines such public interest? If the courts find that there is no such public interest after such disclosure is made, the state will have no recourse as the harm will have been done as a result of such disclosure.
The vote on the bill has been delayed because the IFP tabled 123 amendments, forcing Parliament to reconstitute an ad hoc drafting committee until next Tuesday to consider them. And lastly, President Jacob Zuma says both government and business delegation from South Africa and Oman will work together to ensure that all agreements that they have entered into are implemented. He was speaking to the SABC at the end of his two-day visit to the Arabian country. During his stay in Sultanate State, Zuma witnessed the signing of an agreement of the avoidance of double taxation and visited the port of Soha near the Persian Gulf. President Zuma says they have all committed to follow up on these agreements. Catch the latest news anytime here on NewsBreak Option 1.